I'm going to present on the impact of mvuza on crop yields, weed density, weed species diversity, and soil quality across agroecological regions of Zimbabwe. First, I would like to define conservation agriculture, CA. Basically, it's a smart agriculture. It's a climate smart agriculture system, which is based on three pillars. Number one, minimum tillage, which could be planting basins or ripping. Two, soil cover. Three, crop rotation. This was reported by Majumai. Now, farmers often fail to implement the three pillars. Fumvudza is basically conservation agriculture with the same three pillars. But with Fumvudza, the area has been reduced to 3 meters times 16 meters so that farmers can actually focus on that small area. For maize, the plant spacing is 75 times 60 centimeters, and for sorghum, it's 75 times 30. The seed is 5 kg, you have got 12 kg lime, 50 kg compound D, and 50 kg ammonium nitrate. The advantage of conservation agriculture is timely planting. Basically, you have planting holes which are dark, and you have mulch which is covering the soil. There are different levels of mulch, as you can see from that slide. That person is applying top dressing. Now, Fumvudza or conservation agriculture is affected by weed problems. Now, this system allows weeds to emerge before crop emergence. And usually weeds which emerge ahead of crops have a competitive advantage. So timely weeding becomes very crucial. In fact, weeding should commence before crop emergence. It has been shown that weed biomass was higher in conventional tillage compared to basins and ripped plots. It was the presence of the mulch which tended to reduce the weed biomass. But in contrast, area studies had shown that there were higher weed biomass in the conservation agriculture compared to conventional tillage. It was also demonstrated that weeding was 2.7 times higher in conservation agriculture compared to 1.7 up to 1.9 times in the conventional tillage. So basically, we are having differences in the reports. Some researchers associate conservation agriculture with a lot of weeds, others report the opposite. The differences could be accounted for by the type of mulch and amount of mulch which was used in these studies. So the mulch is the key to probably the success of CA or of Mvudza. Now, most of the weeds which are reported in CA are annual weeds, but we do have parasitic weeds which are a problem, especially in natural region 3, 4, and 5. Now, where you have a striga, it can damage the crop before emergence. Even if the farmers want to weed this, remove this weed, they cannot remove it. They can only see it after the damage. And some farmers may not even bother to weed. Now, this weed is serious in places where there's low nitrogen and phosphorus. And most of the maize hybrids are susceptible to this weed. This is the striga in Gokwe. Imagine you have put your Pfumvudza there. It may not succeed. This is a striker. So let us focus on the mulch effects on weeds. Now, the mulch can actually reduce light, which is required to break seed dormancy. So weed seeds become dormant and they will not germinate. In fact, the weed seeds can sense light via a phytochrome system. Now, if you've got light, you can convert PR to PFR, forms of phytochrome. And this can happen on bare soil. And this facilitates germination. Where there is mulch, there is exclusion of light. You can convert PFR to PR, which induces dormancy. So mulch can actually cause weeds to go into dormancy, and they will fail to produce weed seedlings, which are supposed to compete with the crop. Allelopathy is the production of allelochemicals, which can kill weed seedlings. These allelochemicals could be produced by certain types of mulch, for example, sorghum residues, which were reported to kill Acanthospermum hispidum, Erucina indica, and Biden's pilosa. This diagram is showing the weed seed bank dynamics. I just want to explain how useful mulch can be in these systems. Now, the soil contains weed seeds on the surface and within it up to a depth of 30 centimeters. And we refer this system as the weed seed bank. They are inputs into this seed bank. Now, if weeds are allowed to germinate, they produce flowers and then seeds, then they will add seeds into the soil as seed rain, or it is said as seed rain, or it's actually seed dispersal from within the field. There could also be seed dispersal from other areas adding into this system. Usually, we are looking at weeds with wings, which can be blown by the wind. Inside the soil seed bank, the seeds may be dormant. That is, they are not going to germinate, or they become non-dormant and then they start germinating. What can happen is that the mulch can stop seeds from emerging, or they can stop the germination process. Therefore, they reduce the seed rate. Should they get seeds from other areas, the seeds will land on the mulch, which will separate the seeds from the soil. So the seeds won't find the media to do the germination process. And those weeds which are inside the soil profile, it's either they may remain dormant or they become non-dormant, but they are prevented from germination. So they are pushed towards the dormant state. Those which try to germinate may not find light, so they simply die. Now, the seeds are kept dormant by the mulch, and they have a certain lifespan. Most of the weed seeds may remain viable maybe up to 5 years, but of course, there are those which can go beyond 20 years. Does reduce the size of the CA increase weed control efficiency? Probably by reducing this size, the farmers may be able to manage to control these weeds. But of course, with the exception of parasitic weeds. The other issues which are critical to conservation agriculture, soil fertility problems. Most of the soils where this system is operating is that we have low nitrogen, phosphorus, low organic carbon, low soil pH around 4.3 on the calcium chloride scale. Now, this reduces the crop yields. There's also predominance of sandy soils which are prone to leaching, and most of these soils do not, store nutrients. They tend to lose nutrients so quickly that the crop may fail to utilize them. In fact, there are reported cases where the crops frequently do not respond to fertilizer addition. So, is Pfumvudza going to increase crop yields in poor soil fertility environments? Well, there are some reports that CA has improved crop yields. So the aim of this project is to assess the impact of Pfumvudza program on crop yields, weed density, weed species diversity, and soil quality parameters across agroecological regions of Zimbabwe. There are three objectives. The first one is to establish weed density and weed species diversity under Pfumvudza compared to conventional farming methods. The second objective is to determine maize, sorghum crop yields on light, medium, and heavy textured soils in different agroecological regions. And the third, we want to determine the effect of Fumvudza on selected soil quality parameters, for example, soil organic carbon and pH and soil nutrients status. Basically, we are going to do diagnostic surveys. We are going to focus 5 natural regions from 1 to 5. Probably for natural region 1, Bazo and Makonde, we may need to change those because they are not in natural region 1. That is natural region 2. We have some questionnaires, and we are going to collect information on crop production practices for Fumvudza versus conventional farming methods using questionnaires in 5 agroecological regions. We are going to target probably around 40 to 50 farmers on light, medium, and heavy clay soils for each site. Weeds, crops, and soil sampling will be done in 5 agroecological regions of Zimbabwe. There are going to be 2 sites per agroecological region. The questionnaire will focus on these factors with the information which we will get from the farmers, as well as wheat sampling, soil type. We want to know the previous crop or a variety where this Fumvudza is being practiced. We want to know the current crop, planting date, crop emergence problems, fertilizer, basal, top dressing, cattle manure, light, lime, soil analysis, mulch type, weeding frequency, herbicides. Now, when we have got, when we have captured that information, we will then proceed to do sampling in the Fumvudza plot as well as the conventional plot. Ideally, we are going to use quadrats which are 45 times 45 centimeters. Individual weed species will be counted and recorded. The following parameters will be calculated, you know, weed density, weed species richness, weed diversity, weed evenness. So this is the map for a Fumvudza plot, and those are the quadrats where we are going to sample. Then we'll also do a weed seed bank study. What may happen is that we may, because we're now going to do this in June, we may just miss some of the weed species which occurred this season. But we are going to capture that information via a weed seed bank study. What we will basically do is to sample soils from 0 to 10, 10 to 20, and 20 to 30 using augers in both Fumvudza plots versus conventional plots. These soils, 0 to 10, will be composited together, will be combined for each plot. At the use that soils will be put in shallow trays and germination conditions will be created so that we can record the weed seedlings, which can be done, you know, in 3 months. Every 2 weeks, we we can record the wheat seeds. So estimates of wheat seed investment in two systems could be worked out. All right, yes. Now on soil quality parameters and crop yields, Pumvuta plots and conventional tilled plots would be identified on light, medium, heavy textured soils. This is where crop yields will be estimated, and at the same time, soil samples will be taken from 0 to 20. These will be composited, then they will be analyzed for things like soil organic carbon, pH, exchangeable bases, cation exchange, capacity, total, and mineral nitrogen and phosphorus. The plot sizes will be 4 meters by 4 meters. Now, for the data analysis, basically, we are going to employ the t-test to compare weed species density, total weed density, weed species diversity, species richness, and species evenness between two systems. A table showing weed species distribution across the agroecological zones will be processed. Impact on climate change on weed species shift. The sampled weed species composition will be compared to the composition reported by Chivinge in 1988 in the National Survey. And we may use this equation to estimate weed similarity percentage. This will give us an indication whether there has been some changes at those sites. Then soil analysis, data and crop yield, basically analysis of variance will be done to compare within each agroecological region and between agroecological regions. And RSD will be used to facilitate the comparisons. Now, the expected outcomes, we think we are likely to identify mulches which are allelopathic to weeds. And later on, this could address the problem of weeds in Pumvuta. We are likely to identify amounts of mulch which are effective in reducing weed populations. The target maize hybrids with strike resistance. We're going to target maize hybrids with strike resistance or tolerance to strike hotspots to promote yields in those areas. We can also identify legumes which could be used to improve soil fertility and also have allelopathic effects to weeds. Remember, in our questionnaire, we shall ask what was the previous crop before that Pumvuta plot was established. We are thinking that the previous crop would enable us to probably identify some of the crops which either increase soil fertility or reduce weeds. In the long term, because there has been some work on biochar, which can actually help the soil to store nutrients and regulate pH. We may experiment with the biochar in these systems so that we can stabilize soil fertility. This is the work plan. We were planning to have started this program probably earlier in May or April or thereabouts. We've got the Department of Soil Science and Environment. We've got Professor Uta, Dr. Nezomba, Dr. Rolinda, Ms. Gafata, and they are going to put some students in plant production science and technologies. We've got myself and Dr. Rugari. We've got five MSc students. We've got Madzimure Innocent, Kudanga Moses, Viola Manyota, Ian Kasuni, Nyarai Betera. This is the team. Thank you.